Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear students, I hope all of you are fine and studying at home and giving a proper time to your studies. And I hope all of you are preparing for your practicals, the work that we are doing nowadays. So if you remember, I am giving you the practical assignments on a regular basis. If you go to your Google class and see the work that has been assigned to you. So we have done these three practicals, and you know what is basically the format. Let me check the status. Some students have submitted, but some students still they have not submitted the work. So these are the four practicals that we have done up to now. So I would like to ask you that what kind of problems are there that you are facing right now? Because today I'm not going to demonstrate any new practical, but some problems were there asked from different students. So that I'm going to cover today, and I'm going to demonstrate about Microsoft Word as well. Okay. So I would like to ask you that if you have any question, please note it down and you can ask me. If you are facing any problem, any issue, anything like that. First, we come to our last activity that we were doing in our last class. It was about the practical number four. And one portion that we did at the end, it was requiring some more explanation, but since our class time was over, so I completed it quickly. But we must know that what was basically the question. The question we had done for Word and Excel, we had done. The question was there that in the in page, this was the portion that we did last time, and it was not done completely. Excel was done. Excel we had completed, but I gave you the in page work and I ask you that you have to do at your own. Okay, so this is basically the task that you were supposed to do last time. What do you have to do? Type this text, number one. Type this text, type the lines and save the file with your name. Put a rounded rectangle in red color to the heading. Number second point, put a rounded rectangle to the heading in red color. Apply left align to the passage with font size 18 points. Change font color of the passage in blue color. So basically these were the tasks that we performed last time. Let me open Urdu in page. The new versions of in page are almost getting rich, and they are also having some good options to draw simple objects as well. Okay. So that's why I gave you a simple task to apply a rounded rectangle to the heading. This was basically the task that we are supposed to do. And before that, we had done a word assignment. It was not that much difficult, quite easy. Then Excel assignment was there that I had given to you, and then afterwards the assignment which is there is about the Urdu in page. Okay, now it has been opened. So this was the task that we were supposed to do. This is the text that you will type. Of course, it will take time to be typed, and it is your assignment that you need to accomplish it. Okay, you have to type this paragraph number one. Convert the paragraph to 18 points. Select this paragraph. Go to 12, the font size over here. Select 18 point. Now you can see that we have applied size 18 to our paragraph quite easily. Put a rounded rectangle. We have to save it. We have already saved it. In last class, we had done this thing that it is already saved. Put a rounded rectangle in red color to the heading. What we will do? Now you can see over here right now, we have mouse cursor that is available in our Urdu in page. When we will go to this option, which is basically arrow. Arrow is used basically to draw different objects and to place those objects at different locations. What I am going to do, I am going to take this rounded rectangle and I am going to draw this rounded rectangle. Okay, this kind of rectangle you can draw. If you don't think that it is good, you can select it and you can press delete. It will be deleted. So I need to have this one. I think this is looking better. Rounded rectangle with the corners in the borders in the red color. So it is also mentioned that the border should be in red color. So what I am going to do, I am going to take the border. Just like black is there, gray is there. When I double clicked on it, I can see over here. So I am going to apply red color border to it. This is the red border. So I have selected this red border from here. Now this red border that you can see over here, we have taken the full design because there are some designs as well. When we double click on it, this object appears. You can see over here, some different things are there in it. Just like red border, what is the pattern? It is full line or dash line or dotted line. So we have taken, of course, full line over here. And what is the point width? Width is 0.1. Now we can change it to 5 points so that it should be quite visible that this is the rounded rectangle that we have applied. I have changed the location using my arrow keys. In this way we can do, and you have to explore these options. When you double click the border, find out and explore these options. What will happen if I do this? Just like dotted border is there, full border line border is there, double line border is there. Okay, some different designs and some different styles are there. So you have to explore them. It's basically your task to explore them. Some different designs are there that you are going to see. So I have taken by default the default one, which is full line border in 5 points. Okay. Number next point is there, apply left align to the passage in font size 18. We have already applied the font size 18. Now you can see that the mouse cursor is not coming because I have taken this arrow. I will click on this hand symbol, then mouse cursor will come. Now the rectangle is disappeared, but does not mean that the rectangle is not saved. When you will click on this arrow button, you will be able to see, because arrow button, this arrow tool is there to show you the drawing objects, whatever you have drawn in your work. And this hand tool is basically showing you the mouse cursor whenever you are doing any typing work. So I am going to take the passage color in blue, in blue color, because they have asked us to apply blue color on it. And passage font size is 18 point, fine, it is 18 point. And we need to make it left align. Select the text, this is center align, this is left align, this is left align, this is right align. So we have to make it left align. This is called left align. Left align when normally the Urdu passage is by default right align, normally. But since the question is that we have to make it left align, so we have made it left align in blue color with 18 point font size. So I don't think so you are going to face any problem. You have to explore these all options. So I am going to save it now. This work is done. So this was basically the last practical that we have accomplished, practical number 4. Now come towards the questions that the students are asking. Some students were asking about the office because they were using cell phones and now they are working on the you know. So over here I will write on the desktop PC. So I will write free download Microsoft Office full version 2013. 2000, why I'm mentioning 2013? Because 2013 is normally easily available free of cost and you will be able to find out quite easily. Otherwise 2016 could also be available. There are less differences, but there are differences. But according to our syllabus, we are not going to face any problem in 2013 as well. So you will write down Office 2013 full version. You will press enter. You will see a number of videos are coming over here. You're not going to see the videos. Just open any of these videos. Just stop the video and go to the video description. Over here, you are going to find the link from where you can download. In almost each and every video, this happens that you are going to download. So using this way, you can find out any software. For example, now I will click on the download button. Downloading has been initiated. Of course, it will take some time and it will be downloaded in my computer. Fine. So in this way, we can download a number of softwares. Sometimes when you download, it is in a compressed file. Compressed file, you know, compressed file is the file which contains this kind of icon. Can you see this? This is a compressed file. WinRAR is the software. You can see the read the description. What is written? WinRAR archive. So you need to unzip this. You need to have WinRAR installed in your computer. So if you don't have the WinRAR, so what you are going to do? You are going to write over here WinRAR download for Windows 10 or Windows 7, whatever Windows you are using. So you will click on it. Then you will be able to have the WinRAR free of cost, free download. Click on the video, stop the video. If you don't want to see the procedure, stop, just stop the video, go to the more options and find out over here the link. Just like they have given you download WinRAR from here. We'll open this link. And then why I'm telling you about WinRAR, because sometimes you install some software, that software is in the zip format and you are unable to unzip it. You need to have the WinRAR software for it. So you must have WinRAR installed in your laptop. So that's why I'm just describing this procedure as well, that if you are facing, some students were asking about it. So you can go and you can download WinRAR free version of the WinRAR. It is available. And then you can download it quite easily in your computer system. Okay, but right now it's let me check over here on this link. Okay, we need to find out the free version. So we will write, if you are unable to find in one link, you can go to any other link, just like this one. We go to this link and stop the video. Although this is also going to start, the download has been started in the previous one as well, where I clicked. But I'm just telling you that you can find out the WinRAR from different locations if one is not working. Okay, so this is not a difficult thing. So now you can see over here, I have downloaded the WinRAR software, and I have also near to the completion of the office. I will go to the downloads, and I can see over here that the WinRAR is there. Here is the WinRAR. So what you are going to do, you will open it and you will run it. It will ask you, do you want to run this software? It is going to make changes in your device. You are going to say yes, and then it will be installed. Since in my computer, it is already installed. So that's why I'm not going to install it again and again. And how can I check this? If I go to the start menu, if I type over here, WinRAR, I will be able to see that WinRAR is already installed in my computer. Okay, over here you can see that WinRAR software is already installed in my computer, and I can unzip different kind of files using this WinRAR. It is showing you in my start menu where I can see different programs installed on my computer. So you can install it from this link that I have given you. What I am going to do, that I am going to give this link where I had clicked. This is the link. Okay, so I am going to give you these all links in your today. It is 10th. Okay, so the link has been loaded. When you will click on it, so you'll be able to use this link. Okay, what was the other link for your office? This was the link for the office. I'm also giving you the same link in the Google Classroom, hence you can download it. If someone is there who is unable to use, so he can download it from here. Okay. Now you can see that my Office download is also complete. Can you see this in my downloads? Office 13 has been downloaded. So you will go and you will see in the downloads that the Office 13 is downloaded. Now for this thing, I was telling you that since it is a zip file, I am cutting it and I am bringing it on my desktop. Since it is a zip file, so we are not able to use it unless we make it unzipped. So we will need the WinRAR for this. Right click on it, go to open with, open this archive, and using this way, extract here. I'm clicking on extract here. So now this will make another folder which will be basically an unzipped folder. Can you see this? This is the folder that has been created. This was the folder that I downloaded in the zipped format, and this is the folder that has been created when I unzipped this folder. Of course, when the zip folder is of 530 MB, of course, then the unzip folder will be in more in size, just like it is in 609 MB. So now it has been unzipped. This was the file that I downloaded. When I unpressed it, now this is the folder. Now open this folder. You will see the setup file over here. Double click on it. it will ask you that you are almost about to run the setup. You will click on yes button and the installation will start. But I am not clicking right now. Why? Because I have already installed Microsoft Office in my computer and Office 2016 is already installed in my PC. You can also download Office 2016. It will also be available. But some websites are there which will ask you for the payment. But if you become able to Office 2016 free download for Windows 10, you will have to mention over here free download. So if you will able to get free, you will have to try from these ones. So one or two, you are going to find some option that is giving you free, then you will be able to. So it's better that you should install Office 2016. So it's up to you. If your computer is fast enough and you can use it quite easily, so it's up to you. If you are using Windows 7, you will mention for Windows 7. So you will be able to have for Windows 7, although there isn't any difference, but it happens that you need to find out, of course, the latest version. But don't go after the 2016, because after 2016, those versions will be there and these will not be properly cracked and you are going to face some problems over there. Okay, so you can go and you can find out any of the softwares over here and go to the link. Just like this is the link, we can go to this link and we will click over here. What are the links given over here? Office 2016, here is the link. WinRAR is also given over here. Okay, so we will right click on it, we'll go there and we'll see that it is giving us the option to download the Office 2016. We will click on it and we'll be able to download Microsoft Office. Okay, so this is the way that we can do this thing. Now I have explained you already how to download Office 2013. You can also do the same thing for Office 2016 as well. Okay, now I'm going to close these all things up to here. If you have got any question, you can ask me. Now let me open Microsoft Word. In Word, if you are facing any problem, I am going to explain you. I'm going to give you a brief demonstration about Microsoft Word. What kind of operations are there available in different menus, how we can use these menus. We are going to see one by one different types of commands and we are going to see all these things. This is a complete demonstration, inshallah, that we are going to see in this class for Microsoft Word. We are not specifically doing any practical, but we are going to explore these all options which are available over here. Okay, now let's suppose if I am searching for some text, for example, I say computer network types. Okay, now I am going to download or I'm going to have some text or some data about the networks. And what I need to do, how can we do this thing? For example, this is one text that I have copied. I'm going to copy it from here. I'm going to paste it over here. Now it is having a black white background. No such issues are there. Okay, fine. But sometime you are going to see that when we copy some data from the internet, it is having some background colors as well with it. Okay, some specific formatting is there sometimes with it. For example, if I'm copying these points, so you may find that some specific formattings are there with it, colors are there with it. The text that we have written, it has some specific color with it, some formatting is there with it. So how we are going to deal with it, such kind of thing in Microsoft Word. Now see over here, if you want to, we will start from the file menu. File menu contains which options, new, you know about it, to take a new file, open to open a file, save and save as. There is a difference between save and save as. When you save the file first time, then you click on the save file. I am going to browse and I will save it on my desktop with the name of temporary file one on my desktop. I have saved it. Okay, what is the difference between save and saved as? So what is going to happen that if I want to make some other changes without touching the previous file, so I will click on the save as will make another copy. So we are going to save it, let's suppose, with the name of temporary file 2. So this, in this way, the previous text which is there in the previous file will be saved, and we will make the amendments in the next file. Save as Adobe PDF. What is the option over here? For example, if you want to make a PDF file, so we will go to this option, save as PDF. We'll click on it. I'm going to save on the same on my desktop. Temp2, I'm saving it with the PDF or any name you can give over here. I will click on save button. Then you will see that it has been saved or not. Let me check. Okay. We can save the file using in the form of PDF if we want to save. So we will go to save as PDF. Another option is also there. When we go to save button, save as button, save as. So over here, in the save as button, when we browse the file and when we save, over here even we can change this format to PDF. Over here, this format is available to us. We can click over here, PDF. Let's suppose I am saving it with the name of temp2a. So I'm going to save it over there in this ABC folder. I will click on it. Then we'll be able to see that we have saved one PDF file, because when we are saving the file, of course, it is going to be a PDF. Now you can see over here, temp2a, temporary file 2a has been saved with the name of this file, and this is a PDF file. Why? Because it has been now opened. Can you see this? It has been opened in the PDF version. When I click and when I close it, I can go and I can check where I saved this file. I had saved this file in this folder, in ABC folder. You can see this is the file that I saved right now. This is the file. Okay, so this way we can save the file in PDF format. Print, when the printer is attached, we can go there. We will see the print preview. How many copies you want to print? 2, 3, 5. Of course, here we will select printer. Sometimes we have multiple printers in our lab or in our working environment. So we select that particular printer from where we want to print the work. This will happen in your lab when you will be printing your work, final lab. When you will be having your board exam, you will have to give print. And of course, we will guide you how to give print and which is the printer that you need to select here. Okay, and it is going to show you the print preview, that how it will look like after printing. So you can see over here the print preview, and you'll click on the print button, so it will be printed. But right now, since I don't have the printer installed, so of course the print is not going to be printed. Fine. So in this way, we can print over here from this command. Then share and export. Export option is basically related to any other option, any other format, just like PDF or web page or something like that. Just like if you go to the save as button, you will see over there that there are some different save as options, just like Word template option is there, rich text format is there. This is rich text format, which it is basically WordPad file that we can create over here. Web page, we can convert it to the web page format. Okay, so these are different files formats using which we can convert them in some different formats. Okay, just like now it has been converted. Okay. So this is about the file menu that we have covered over here. We go to the next menu, which is home menu. What are the different options available on home menu? You can see over here. different options available over here on the home menu. We can go to the layout to see the page margins. Margins right now, this is normal. So we can make it narrow, or we can make it, you know, some other margin that we want to apply. Okay, so this is also possible. Anyway, we will start from now, home, and we will see all these options which are available over here. Now, whenever you download some text, you take some text from the internet, it will have some different design, some different formatting. We can select the text and we can click on this button or clear all formatting. It is going to clear all the formatting which is applied on it. Okay, clear all formatting. This is the option that we can do. Select different types of font styles are there that we can select. This is quite easy. You know about it. You can change the font size according to your requirement. You know about it. Similarly, we can make bold, italic, underline, double underline, single underline, dotted underline according to our requirement to the specific area wherever we want to apply that particular thing. For example, if I say that I want to apply over here this double underline, so I can do this double underline. We can change the font color from here. This is the highlighter. We can highlight the text. Only the particular selected text will be highlighted in that particular color that you select from here. Okay, now if this is the option and I want to apply this font design, these are basically different font designs available over here. We can go and we can choose any of the color font design, just like this is the design which is coming with a inside fill color, inside shade. We can go and we can select. If I change its size, then you'll be able to see that basically what kind of design it is. So we can apply this thing quite easily. What is the purpose of the format painter? For example, this is a line. This is a line which is, it is in green, it is in red color, highlighted with the sky blue highlighter. And I have also given italic is not applied and its font design is Algerian, let's suppose. And it's, it is Algerian. And it is in the font size 22. Now, if I want to apply the same formatting to any other line, I will take this, I will click on it, format painter, and I will apply this format wherever I will apply, the same format will be applied to that line quite easily without doing all these things. For example, you had applied Algerian 22 font size, yellow highlighted or blue highlighted in red color font. Now you want to apply the same thing over here on this line. So what you are going to do, you will select this. You will go to this option, format painter. It copies the format, click on it and go to that particular line where you want to apply that format. That formatting will be applied to that particular text as well. Fine. I think this thing is also clear now. What is this purpose of this overline? You are going to make a strike on the text. For example, this is the text. Let me change its size. This is in 22. I will click on it. So it is going to make a cross over the line. So when you are going to show some text which has been crossed, just like when we show, for example, this is the old price, make a cross on it and this is the new price. So in this way, we can do this. Superscript and subscript are there. You know the use of the superscript. For example, if I want to type H2O. So in H2O, you know that 2 is not written in this way. 2 needs to be subscript. I will click on this button. You can see over here this button I click. So now 2 is small. Can you see this? Okay. Similarly, if I want to give the power x, y square. So y square, 2 is square over here. I will click on this superscript. So you are going to make it superscript. We have got the equations as well that we are going to see very soon. Okay, now increase font size and decrease font size. These are the two options available over here. We have got some shortcuts for this as well. If I select this text and I, let's suppose I want to increase the font size. So I will click on it. So it is going to increase the font size by 2 points. Can you see this over here? 2 points increasing. But after some time, it is increasing more points. 2.28, then suddenly 36, then 48. So in this way, we can see that we are going to reduce the point by point depending on our requirement. But same thing we can do with the shortcut control curly bracket close. Control curly bracket close is going to make it 1 by 1 point. control curly bracket close, I'm increasing the size 1 by 1 point, and control curly bracket open is going to reduce the size 1 by 1 point. Okay, in this way we can do this thing. So this is basically that purpose. That is the thing that I had already explained to you: sentence case, lowercase, uppercase. Sentence case, in sentence case, the very first letter right after the full stop, very first letter will be capital, otherwise no other letters will be. Let me make it. Okay, the case is not getting applied to it, but what I am going to do, I am going to apply first clear formatting, all formatting, clear all formattings, and then I am going to apply this thing. Let me change the size 22. Okay, now you can see over here, I select this paragraph and I go there and I say that lowercase, all the text is in lower case. Okay, if I will click on the sentence case, the very first letter will be sentence for each sentence. The very first letter will be in capital for each sentence, just like when full stop, then privacy P capital, then access full stop, then increased I capital. Fine, this is the sentence case. If I go to and I select the uppercase, all the letters will be in capital. If I go there and if I select capitalize each word, then all words will be having first letter capital over here, and toggle is opposite of the sentence case. Over here you can see that the first letter for each word is in small, otherwise the rest are in. Normally we take the sentence case. Now come towards the bullets and numberings. Bullets and numberings are applied, you can see over here. Let me mark the attendance because our class time is almost about 2 hours. Why I explained it, because some students were asking some different things that they are facing some problems. So I thought that I should explain some things in detail, and then same we will do inshallah for the Excel and in page as well, so that you can go through it and you should not face any problem. Abdul Aman to Muhammad Ali Kashif, and then to Sayyida Atika. Okay. So those who have not done the practical work and they have not submitted, for what they are thinking? They are thinking that when some call will go to their parents, then they will do the work. Why you are not working and why you are not submitting the work over here? I am unable to understand this thing. I am going to give you today's video over here, just like I have already given you this. Okay. Have you got any question up to here? Can you please ask me anything that you want to ask? Please, any problem that you are facing? I had also shared my number with you, that if